Well, that really burns the back of the throat. Welcome to Woo That's Hot, where the peppers are hotter than this new setup. I hope. Let me know in the comments what you think. I got some new LED lights from Newer. I'm actually using my wife's Canon T6 camera instead of my phone that I normally use. And I got the microphone hooked up directly to my computer instead of hooked up through my phone through an OTG. So hopefully the audio processing and audio quality is better as well. Let me know what you think of everything. Feedback is always welcome, positive or negative. I haven't made any videos in quite a while. I actually did a lot of recording right around COVID-19 in preparation in case I couldn't have guests for a while. And then I started a new job, so I've taken a couple of months off. I'm ready to get back into recording. And with my new setup, I'm able to do a little more plug and play and pump out more content more quickly. So hopefully we'll get some new fun videos coming out. Today's video is a review of my first ever Fuego box. This box is actually from April. It's been sitting in my basement for a couple of weeks, and I've been real excited to try it out for you guys. So one of the sauces is from Pex Peppers. It's called Pineapple, Reaper, and Pineapple Hot Sauce. Check that out. So the ingredients here are Reaper chili mash, which consists of Carolina Reapers, distilled white vinegar, and then there's more distilled white vinegar, pineapple, and honey. That's it. So it's basically Reaper and honey and some pineapple. That's probably gonna be pretty warm. And then we have Sinclair's Fatalii Hot Sauce, Sweet Heat Gourmet. So the ingredients on this are apple cider vinegar, Fatalii peppers, tomato paste, carrots, water, pure cane sugar, lime juice, salt, cumin, paprika, turmeric, ginger, and lemon zest. That sounds really interesting. Pretty flavorful. I'm obviously gonna go with the less hot sounding sauce first, because I wanna, you know, start a little slow and then go into the heat. All right. Woo. Shake this bad boy up. I've got a lot of content coming up as well, guys. You know, if you've sent me something and you're waiting, trust me, it'll be coming out soon. I'm gonna try to be putting out videos, no promises, but I'm gonna try to be putting out videos 2 to 3 times a week instead of just once a week. Try to get more of this content out, get more stuff sent to me, and really just go to town with this. I'm gonna try maybe to do a little less editing, so, you know, we can just pump the content out. If I have a little bit of dead air, don't worry about it. So I got this Mother of Pearl spoon finally in the, you know, the hot sauce game with the rest of you big YouTubers. The Mother of Pearl is supposed to not add any other flavors that a metal spoon would add, or even plastic. And also, it's not bad for the environment, like a plastic spoon that you throw away. So let's give that a go. This sauce is really thick, hard to get out. Let's not break the Mother of Pearl. All right. So just looking at these ingredients while I taste it, so I have a better idea of what we're going for here. Also, you can get this sauce if you're curious. It says at, you can email them at hi@sweetheatgourmet.com. So I'm assuming they also have a website, sweetheatgourmet.com, if you're interested in it. Yep, here it is, sweetheatgourmet.com. All right. Now this is also supposed to be pretty hot. I'll say that both of these sauces are from the hot section. Like, you have two options with Fuego box. You can just get mild to hot sauces and get 3 bottles. Or if you're really into super hot stuff, you can get the 2 super hot bottles, and that's what I subscribe to. So both of these should have a decent heat, but the Reaper Mash obviously sounds a bit hotter than what we have here. So without any further ado, let's give it a taste. The texture is really good. Like a real good chunk mouthfeel. Instead of like a runny sauce, it's like a thick, you know, almost like a chopped puree. and there's like citrusness. It's funny, I'm reading it now, and that's what it says. It says, the perfect balance of heat and mild citrus flavor. Fatalii peppers are featured in this fiery sauce that goes great on fish tacos, grilled shrimp, ceviche, quesadillas, eggs, pizza, and pizza. This sauce was named after Sinclair, an 8-year-old who brought his homegrown Fatalii peppers to Michelle years ago and asked her to make a hot sauce. Well, that's interesting. Wow, like, the flavor on this, I'm really getting, you know, my tomato paste kind of comes through, but I would say that more than anything, I'm really getting that the spices, you know, there's like ginger, cumin, turmeric, even though the lemon zest is the last ingredient, it kind of comes through because it's such a strong flavor. The carrots are kind of there, but I feel like they're more for texture than flavor, and that heat really comes in on the front of your tongue, and it lasts for just long enough that you want a little bit more. So I'm gonna try just a little bit more, and then I'll move on to the pain apple with the hornet on it. Hopefully it's not a murder hornet. Oh yeah, that's good. I got a little seed there. That's really good stuff. I'm gonna use this hot sauce up pretty quickly, I'm sure. So my favorite part about finally opening the hot sauce is then I could just eat it on everything instead of storing it and waiting for the video. Now we have the dreaded Pex Peppers Pineapple Reaper and Pineapple Hot Sauce. Now, I don't see perforation on this, so it's gonna be fun to try to open. Usually, in a situation like that, I would just try to twist it with the thing still on it and cheat my way through it like this. And I sealed that real well. All right, we'll edit through that noise. All right. So we got her open. Man, and again, like the other one, I got like a thick chunk at the top. It's kind of blocking the sauce from coming through. There we go. All right, guys, let's give it a go. I love pineapple, by the way. Probably my favorite fruit, so I'm really curious to try this. I'm surprised. Well, that really burns the back of the throat. That's warm. That's warm, boys. And girls. Oh. On a scale of 1 through 10, I'm sorry, in the last sauce I should have said that on a scale of 1 to 10, the heat was like a 6. And the flavor was like an 8. This sauce here, though, the heat on a scale of 1 through 10, probably about an 8. Not the hottest thing I've ever tried, but man, it is warm. Holy cow. Warmer than most. This might be the hottest, like, non-extract sauce I've ever tried, as far as just the pain on my tongue. Oh my. It's dying down now. But what I was gonna say before the heat kind of kicked in is I'm surprised at how much the pineapple flavor actually comes through on this. It comes through strong. Yeah, because, you know, it being the last ingredient, even though there's technically only like 2 ingredients, so I guess it's not really fair, but pineapple comes through really strong in the beginning, really sweet flavor to start off, and then this little murder hornet here starts stinging the crap out of your tongue. Oh, definitely check that out. You can visit them at pexpeppers.com, P-E-X. PEPPERS.com. So check them out. Check out the Sweet Heat Gourmet. Check out the Pex Peppers. I recommend both of these. And also, guys, subscribe to your own personal Fuego box. And go to FuegoBox.com. It's FuegoBox.com. I'm going to drop a link to all those things in the show notes. as well as a link to buy awesome merchandise like this hoodie that I'm wearing right now. teespring.com/stores/WTH for Woo That's Hot. That about wraps this video up, guys, though. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Woo! That's hot.
Oh, hi there. Fancy meeting you here. Do you love this hot content? Do you need more? Well, you're in luck. Click above. You can subscribe there. Or perhaps you can check out my other videos to the left. But first, subscribe. Hit that logo up there. Hit it, then hit subscribe. Then check out my other videos. Do it.